Lindsay Lohan, and today I'm going to be interviewed by this cookie jar. This is a tough one. Lindsay, there's a scene in Falling for Christmas where your character tells her insecurities to a horse. Unlike me, a talking bunny, the horse in the movie can't talk back. If you could speak to an animal, which animal would it be, and what would be the first question you ask them? Maybe a shark, just because they're so fascinating. I don't know what I would ask, though. It's too wild to think of what I would ask a shark. Like, don't bite me? In the movie, Cord spills hot chocolate on you. If Cord were to spill your order from Starbucks onto you, what would that drink be? Iced green tea lemonade, sweetened, or iced matcha with coconut milk. You've traveled the world and lived all over the place, including New York, Los Angeles, Mykonos, Dubai, and London. If you had been trapped for eternity in the world of a movie you've been in, which setting would you choose to put down roots? Don't worry, you can bring your family and friends, and me. I think I would still stay in Dubai and convince my family to move there so that they would all be closer to me. And you can come. Your first feature film was The Parent Trap in 1998. For nearly 2.5 decades, the character Meredith Blake, played by Elaine Hendricks, was widely seen as the villain of the movie. Recently, however, the Justice for Meredith Blake movement has gained support, with Elaine Hendricks herself pointing out the many ways that twins Annie and Hallie use pranks to terrorize their dad's girlfriend. Level with me. Was Meredith Blake the actual hero of The Parent Trap? I think Hallie and Annie were the heroes of The Parent Trap. And Natasha Richardson for listening to her daughters. But we love Elaine Hendricks. Lindsay, I am falling behind in my Christmas shopping. Please help me with some inspiration. What is the best Christmas gift you've ever received or given? When I was really little, I swore Santa Claus was in the house when I was downstairs looking for him. So that would be the best gift on Christmas Eve, is almost seeing Santa. Lindsay, when you were 12, you went on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno and told him that you always scrape the mustard off your burgers from McDonald's. What condiment would you not ever scrape off a burger because it's so delicious? The onions. I always get extra onions and extra ketchup. And I only take the mustard off of burgers. I do like mustard, so. But I would keep the onions and the pickles. You have an original song in Falling for Christmas. You also had songs on the soundtracks for Freaky Friday, Confessions of a Teenage Drama Queen, Herbie Fully Loaded, and The Princess Diaries 2, Royal Engagement, which you weren't even in. That's a funny way to say it, cookie jar. What's another movie you weren't in that you'd love to create a song for? Maybe like if they remade an Anne Margaret movie, Bye Bye Birdie or something. You interview guests and share your favorite things, people, places, and ideas on your podcast, The Lowdown with Lindsay Lohan. From one interviewer to another, how would you rate my skills on a scale of 1 to 10? I think you have great questions, but they're not in depth enough. So you're a 7. Lindsay, you shared with Vogue that you made the decision for your character Hallie in The Parent Trap to wear blue hard candy nail polish, and that you always make a little last minute decision for your characters. What did you decide about Sierra and Falling for Christmas that wasn't in the script?
Ooh, this is a hard one.
I think we decided on a piece of jewelry, like a statement piece of jewelry that we had decided her mother had given her. And it was this little Cartier necklace that she wore. So that was one thing that we did for Sierra. Lindsay, have you watched Stranger Things 4? If so, what song would save you from Vecna?
Oh, there's so many that I could think of. Okay, maybe a Dido song, something very calming just to save me.
You narrated the British reality dating show Love Struck High, where contestants go back to high school and compete to become prom king and queen. Your character Katie in Mean Girls gave one of the most epic prom queen acceptance speeches of all time after Miss Norberry, aka Tina Fey, let her go to prom. If you had to teach a high school class, which subject would you teach?
I would teach maybe history. I think, yeah, I would teach history.
Okay, Jar, I think I've told you enough. It's time to go. Thanks for watching. Falling for Christmas is now streaming on Netflix.